Kiernan? 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 Kiernan!
Present. Welcome to GNC News.
All right, starting off, our very own Luke Skywalker, Mark Hamill, denies having apparently almost died on the set of Star Wars. Apparently, according to rumors, he almost fell to his death. According to the actor, that did not happen, which just goes to show that he is an actual Jedi in real life and saved himself using the Force.
Rupert Wyatt has now left the Channing Tatum Gambit movie. I mean, it could be, no matter what, it's still going to be better than X-Men Origins. Yeah, that's a plus.
I mean, you know.
Even though I like Taylor Keach. But, in my opinion, they should be doing another. If they're going to do one Ghostbusters, he needs to be in the other Ghostbusters. That's all I'm saying.
Continuing on my little Star Wars tangent, here's the latest rumor. Apparently, all six Star Wars films will be coming to Netflix, which will improve all of you Star Wars fans' Netflix and chill games immensely.
But wait, wouldn't it be called Force and Chill?
Oh, let's not get to what they might call it.
Scott Glenn has returned his stick for Daredevil Season 2, which I'm excited for. Daredevil, good show. Watch it, like, yesterday. I mean, we did have the recommendation meeting yesterday, so there you go. There's one more for the list.
Well, that's a good recommendation, but moving on to movies. Assassin's Creed, the movie, has started filming and will be released on December 21st, 2016. Just gotta wait a little longer for some Templar blood.
That's pretty cool. Pacific Rim 2 has been halted indefinitely, which we all know is the sequel to Guillermo del Toro's big metal alien baby.
You know, it's Godzilla meets Transformers, kind of.
Yeah, basically. But, you know, in all honesty, Guillermo, I'm talking to you personally. I'm not that upset, to be honest with you, because you know what, man? I'm talking to you too now, Perlman. You can also, Mr. Ron Perlman, you can watch this too. I need Hellboy 3. I need it in my life. Please.
Mr. Perlman, Mr. Del Toro, you don't understand. Matt only has so many years left of his life. I think he has at least 70 left. He needs Hellboy 3.
I need it, like, now. Please.
I mean, I'm not saying it's going to prevent his death, but
it'll make me want more Hellboy, but that's a whole other issue.
That's something he has to live with. Now, seeing as how we are graphic novels, I'm sure many of you are familiar with Andy Kubert's Dark Knight 3. What some of you may not know is that it is being used as the program cover for New York Comic Con, which just goes to show, if it's Batman related, it's already better than everything else.
That's a fair point. So G.I. Joe creators seek to reobtain the rights from Hasbro, which begs the question all of us are wondering, why? And you know what, G.I. Joe creators, I'm talking to you personally.
My personal messages today.
Yes, this is the theme of today, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Why? I mean, haven't we suffered enough? I mean, also the fact that supposedly we're also getting a Transformers universe, which they may be a part of.
Wait, stop right now. You're telling me that Robo Jesus himself, Optimus Prime, can share the limelight with Dwayne The Rock Johnson?
Look at the people's elbow. That's what's going to happen to him.
People's transforming elbow.
Exactly.
Please but, don't.
And my other question for you in your last movie, it's been more than a year, so it's not that much of a spoiler. If it's a spoiler, you're lucky, because it means you haven't seen the movie.
God bless you.
Why kill Duke? He's your main character! What? You know what? Let's go to movies.
Please. Let's go to movies. Alden Shane, please get this bad taste out of my mouth. Please. Please.
I'm new to the GNC Newsroom. His name is Shane, and he's going to be helping me with this segment, all right? So, now you know him. Now we're going to talk about a couple movies coming out this weekend. First movie we're going to be talking about, that I'm going to be discussing, is The Maze Runner Scorched Trials. The Maze Runner Scorched Trials is stars, what was that guy again? He was Dylan O'Brien. He was Styles from Teen Wolf. I think he's still on that show, probably. I tried to catch up on Teen Wolf, that didn't really work out so well. Anyway, The Maze Runner Scorched Trials is basically, it's based on a book, and it's about a bunch of kids who create this group called the Gladers. And in this movie, which The Maze Runner Scorched Trials is actually a sequel to the original movie, The Maze Runner. And in this movie, they're trying to fight against an organization called the WCKD. And basically, they're trying to figure out who this organization is and trying to fight against them because apparently these guys are like the bad guys. And the Gladers are the good guys. Dylan O'Brien, Styles, is one of them, one of the Gladers. Tried to fight against them. And that's basically the plot from what I understand. Do I think it's going to be good? I didn't see the first one, so I can't really judge how the first one is. I heard it was decent enough, but not great. This might be the same. I honestly don't know. I'm not interested in seeing it. You know, that's just my personal opinion. I'm not really going to watch it because I'm just not. It hasn't caught my attention. If you guys are interested in it, if you guys probably like the first one, you might like the second one. I honestly don't know, but that's how I feel about it. All right? That's the Maze Runner Scorch Trials.
But let's not forget, Lord Baelish is in the Scorch Trials.
Oh,
for anybody who watches Game of Thrones, Lord Baelish, Peter Baelish.
Okay, I don't watch Game of Thrones, so I didn't know that. But yeah, so if you've seen Game of Thrones, then that guy's on Maze Runner.
Oh, yes.
So yes, now we're gonna go to Shane with the other movie that he wants to talk about.
It's called The Fifth Wave. It's actually very funny that you brought up a young adult science fiction film because this is also a young adult science fiction film.
Okay.
Which not only looks like The Maze Runner. It also feels like The Hunger Games, and it also feels like Insurgent. It's basically, it's very generic, but I'm really not sure how to feel about this. The two stars are very, they're not as well known.
All right, so they're not like
Chloe Grace Moretz and Nick Robinson.
Wait, Chloe Grace Moretz or Chloe Grace Moretz?
Moretz.
Moretz.
Oh, Moretz.
Wait, isn't that Hit Girl from Kick-Ass?
Is that really Hit Girl?
Yes, it is.
Oh my God. Okay. Well, I'm, to be honest, I've never seen that movie.
Okay.
But yeah, it's Chloe Grace Moretz and Nick Robinson. By the way, for anybody who doesn't know, The Fifth Wave is actually based off of a novel by Yancey. Rick Yancey.
Yeah, Rick Yancey, not Yancey Castro, our president.
You see what I did there, right?
Yeah, that's funny.
I think you just gave Yancey a couple million dollars for those couple seconds.
I sure as hell did.
You probably did.
You can thank me later,
yeah.
So. The thing about the Maze Runner, I'm sorry.
Fifth Wave.
The Fifth Wave.
They're both the same,
sorry.
So I understand. Don't
worry, exactly the same, so hold on a second. So the Fifth Wave is about the apocalypse. And in this apocalypse, there are five waves that the aliens cause to our planet. The first wave is taking out all the electricity. The second wave is a devastating earthquake that shakes up the entire Earth. The third wave is a disease. The fourth wave is the alien invasion. The fifth wave is actually the fact that all aliens can now take over the hosts of humans. So now nobody can be trusted. It's all up to the main character, played by Chloe Grace Moretz, to find her little brother in the wake of all this while she trains to become a soldier that fears nothing. See, it's exactly like Insurgent, and it's exactly like The Hunger Games.
Oh, wow. Damn. The book, so it's actually based on a book, right?
Yes, it's based on a book. Same title.
All right, sorry, so we're not going to get into the whole conflict of whether or not it's, you know, a copy, you know, it was copied or plagiarized or whatever that, but all you need to know is that The Fifth Wave exists, it's coming out,
yes.
And also The Maze Runner Scorch Trials is coming out. Both are similar films. Maybe you can watch them both and decide which you think is better or whatever. That's up to you guys.
If
right?
you're into that kind of stuff.
That's up to you. Me, not really. But anyways, that is our movie segment. Thank you all for watching. Remember, guys, at the end of the day, we still have Star Wars The Force Awakens coming out in 91 days. You know.
Woo!
Yep, you know I'm excited for it. You know Anthony's excited for it. I'm sure Shane is excited for it.
This comes out on a Friday, by
yes.
the way. I just found that out today.
Yes, this is coming out on Friday.
Yeah.
Am I going to go on the first day? I don't know. Probably that's going to be a struggle.
About five times the first day.
Anyway, all right. Anyways, thank you guys again. Thank you guys for watching our segment. And we're going to go to the classic movies with Anthony and Matt.
Hello. Welcome to a segment I like to call the Classic Movie of the Week. I'm Matt, as you saw before.
I'm Anthony, as you all saw before. I will not be talking about classics, so to speak. I'll mainly be talking about a couple movies that came out on this day, specifically September 17th. Throughout time.
Which they could be classics, but
they could be, you know, one day. One that I don't really think will be a classic, but you know, it's a good movie starring Emma Stone, came out 2010, Easy A, has its followers. I'm not a particular fan, but you know, I'll throw a shout out for all the followers out there. Is there a Christine in the house?
I'm here.
Also coming out September 17th, 2010, let's talk about the future Batman, Ben Affleck, in the town. Ladies and gentlemen, boys, girls, ferrets of all ages, if you have not seen The Town,
please press pause on this movie and go watch it now. Please. I mean, it also helps that this movie, like I said, it's in Boston. It takes place in Boston.
The fact that it takes place in Boston, you know, almost made me not watch it, but it's a good movie. Trust me.
I mean, they pull for Robin from it's so cool.
It just shows you just how bad Boston is.
Shut up, man! All right. and all joking aside,
it's a good movie. Go
it
watch
is a very good movie. But yeah, let's talk about classics for a second. All right, this is the moment of all moments, the classic movie. We're talking about Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters stars Bill Murray, Harold Ramis, Dan Aykroyd, Sigourney Weaver, and it's directed by Ivan Reitman. I can't remember the other one's name to save my life, but he was one of my favorite characters in the movie. But it takes place in New York City in the 80s, and these team of scientists, which the main three, which was Dan Aykroyd, Harold Ramis, RIP, and Bill Murray, they lost their jobs as like big scientists. What did they decide to do? Every other rational person who loses their job does become Ghostbusters. I mean, if you don't, like, but seriously, who are you going to call? If you can't answer that question for me right now, pause this movie, pause this episode of this thing on YouTube or whatever. Find me in the graphic novel page or put it up in the graphic novel page and tag me, Matthew, whatever. It'll come up because we're on the graphic novel page and answer that question. If you can't answer that question, can you answer that question, Tariq? Can you answer that question, Tariq?
Tariq, I will smack you after this segment, okay? Unfortunately, I don't have time to smack you because now we have to move on in life. We have to move on to our TV segment. So, you know, stay tuned.
Hey, GNC, hope you enjoyed that classic movie segment. Anthony here again. Probably the entire week. You're going to see a lot more of me for the day, though. I'm reprising my segment from last semester talking about TV news. Last semester, I focused on shows that came out that week. This semester, I'm going to be focusing. Well, this day, I'm focusing on it more. What the fuck is that sound? Why is there a police box in here?
Hello, Fonzie. Hello. TV coming this fall is awesome. I just came from the doctor, and we just watched so much fucking TV. Like a lot. Like, we saw Arrow, we saw The Flash, Jessica Jones. It's bigger on the inside.
What the fuck?
Doctor wanted me to tell you and tell everyone.
Who?
The doctor.
Who?
The doctor!
Who?
The doctor!
Oh, you son of a bitch.
He wanted to tell everyone.
What kind of PhD does he have?
All of it. He heals everything.
Oh, God.
He wanted everyone to tell you, this weekend, Doctor Who is back. And, oh boy! I binge-watched this over the summer, and it was great. We have a lot of things this season. We have River Song coming back for the Christmas thing. Maybe she will find out how she got the sonic screwdriver. Maybe we'll find out. And, you know, we'll find out why is Missy alive. Maybe we'll find out more of, you know, why is Clara there. There's a lot of questions. We're going to find out what happened to the silence. There's a lot of questions. And also coming, maybe, rumor is that Rose Tyler is coming back. Rose Tyler is probably one of the best companions, according to Elijah. But wait, there's more. David Tennant is also supposed to be coming back for the final season finale of Doctor Who, Episode X. What may explain why Peter Capaldi, who was in a previous episode, is wondering why he looks like a man he already met.
I'm going to stop you right there for a moment, because I'll be completely honest with you. Of all the words that just came out of your mouth, I understood none of them. However, if, for whatever reason, you understood that, and why there was a police box in here, and it's whatever, it's this weekend, Doctor Who.
All right, so just a little warning here. We're going to be talking about shows that are already developed. You know, they have past seasons. We might mention characters that made it out. Maybe something happened to them. Basically, if it has been mentioned in a trailer that has been released for the upcoming season, it is fair game. You have been warned. No complaints. Now that's out of the way. Let's talk Graphic Novels Club. Let's talk about DC shows on TV. So if we're going to be doing that, let's talk right away. Let's talk Arrow Season 4.
It's going to be greener.
It tends to happen when you have the word green in front of your name. The Green Arrow making an appearance now. Oliver Queen taking his actual comic book persona and bringing it to life.
And it might be greener in the sense of it was hinted very strongly a man might be wearing a ring and might be going brightest day, darkest night kind of thing.
Well, they are in Coast City. The first episode, Oliver Queen and Felicity are in Coast City, which, if you don't know, is the city of the Green Lantern. Hal Jordan, actually, to be exact. And they've been teasing the shit out of Hal Jordan since the series began. So, you know, maybe we'll get Hal Jordan, maybe we'll get a Green Lantern of some kind. We can't really confirm or deny. What we can confirm is that, you know, we got a guy named Damian Dark who can stop arrows just by raising his hand. And
Damian Dark, we have something going on with, you know, the new Ra's al Ghul.
Ra's al Ghul, we won't spoil that because, you know, it actually didn't come out in the trailer, so. We won't spoil who Ra's al Ghul is. Speedy,
you know, Thea Queen.
Thea Queen taking her rightful place as Speedy. Diggle with his new costume, kind of looking like Magneto with the helmet, but, you know, it's growing on me.
And unfortunately Laurel. At least Chaos is coming back for Legends of Tomorrow.
Well, true, Legends of Tomorrow. Let's talk about that. Legends of Tomorrow, the spinoff of Arrow and Flash, featuring heroes and villains from both shows, and they are going to go through time to stop
Vandal Savage.
Vandal Savage. That's a Justice League villain right there, and they got him facing Legends of Tomorrow. So,
Rip Hunter,
you got White Canary, because, you know, Sarah Lance can't keep a good canary down. Heatwave and Captain Cold, should be interesting to see how that goes. You got the Atom, Ray Palmer. You have half of Firestorm. I don't know what the fuck the other half is, but you never know.
They said Firestorm in the trailer, so maybe it's coming. You have Hawkgirl.
You have Hawkgirl, you have Hawkman.
Hawkman.
You have both of the Hawks on this one. And Flash and Arrow apparently will be making appearances every now and again. So that should be interesting, and now that we mentioned it, we can talk about Flash.
Flash. The title of Flash is The Flash, the man who saved Central City, so I guess he saved Central City from the end of Season 1?
Yeah, if you watched Season 1, then you would know that The Flash had a very particular problem that he had to save the city from, but apparently all goes well.
Well, he's going to get help this season.
He's getting a lot of help. They are introducing Jay Garrick, and if you guys don't know, he is The Flash from Earth 2. He is actually the very first Flash from comic books, the original Flash. A lot of people don't know about him because Barry Allen became like the epitome of what The Flash is. But Jay Garrick's coming. A villain named Zoom is coming. For those of you who know him from comics, Hunter Zolomon's his name in the comic books. But apparently they're doing a different thing. They might be making him the rival for TV purposes, but you know, we never know.
Rumored Wally West is coming.
No, Wally West is. They cast Wally West. The rumor is that he might become Kid Flash this season.
Ah.
Basically, might have up to three flashes.
One Quick, right? Jesse Quick?
Jesse Quick has been confirmed, and I think she's going to be a villainess. I'm not entirely sure. But all in all, she'll be good. I'm hoping to see more of her Flash, because that's definitely a good part of the first season. Before we finish with DC, there's one particular member of GNC, and I have good news for you. Matthew Kiernan Jr. Constantine will not be coming back to TV, but he is coming back to Arrow.
So yes, Constantine is saved?
Kind of. He's saved, you know, the characters.
He'll be there. Hopefully, if more episodes, that'd be pretty cool if it comes on as a regular. Ben and Al coming back and forth, you know, doing some magic tricks.
You know, fun fact, Felicity Smoke is supposed to be a one-off character, and now she is one of the main characters of the show. So it is very possible that we get
listen to it a lot more often. It's on the seed.
I have not started Vixen. I'm interested to see what it is.
It's on the seed. There's like 3 episodes out. They're like all the mega short. 5 weeks max.
I might check it out. Let's move on to Marvel. Well, we're not Netflix and chill it. Yes, Jessica Jones is coming to Netflix. It is continuing the Defenders that Daredevil started. So eventually we will get a team just for Netflix. We'll get our own little mini Avengers. We'll get Defenders on TV. Hopefully Jessica Jones as well. For those of you who watch Doctor Who, you should be happy to know that David Tennant is in the show. But he will not be a very friendly man. He is playing the Purple Man, I think is his name. Who is a villain of Jessica Jones, and if they follow the comics, it is going to be very disturbing to see what
it is. But awesome. But David is awesome.
Yeah, David Tennant is awesome. More on Marvel TV, that's about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., when the first season started, I'm not going to lie, I hated the crap out of it. But then the end of the first season happened, and then season 2 happened. Holy shit, they made like a U-turn, because Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is easily like one of my favorite comic books that is out right now. I still like Arrow and Flash better, but that's just personal preference. Like, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is up there with them now. Actually, there is a DC, now that I think about it, there is a DC show we forgot to mention. We have to give props to the cousin of the Man of Steel, Supergirl, is coming to TV.
My name is Kara Zor-El. So that's what's familiar. My name is the same writers?
I don't think it's the same writers as Arrow or Flash, but apparently there are rumors that crossovers can happen, which is interesting because in Supergirl, Superman does exist, and he's been around for quite some time, and if there's a Superman, you know, in the same universe as the Arrow and Flash,
that means maybe there's a Batman? Because, you know, they've been hinting
Dick Grayson for the longest.
Bloodhaven. And you know how much of that dick. Grayson. That's fine. You just move over that way. Maybe get back in the police box.
Actually, you know what? I'll leave. I'll leave. You stay here.
My name is Smiles, aka Steve, aka the Vigilante Training. This is the Secretary of Dreams here. Sleeping right now.
Why? What do you want?
Well, you know, you're kind of cool, and I wanted your autograph.
No.
But you're the secretary of GNC.
No.
Well, then can I ask you some questions?
Fine, if you leave me alone.
So as the secretary...
Do you forget my position?
No, I'm just saying the secretary.
Secretary. Wow, that's my favorite profession. Whipped cream and
dildos. So, as secretary, tell us the day-to-day operations you do.
Well, I sit in this office and pretty much do emails, social media, Instagram, everything under the sun that has to deal with the internet. I am a living meme.
What do you mean?
A living meme.
So, you know, what's the hardest part of the day?
I gotta say the hardest part of the day is probably gonna be afternoon. That's where we get the most members, and it's just like always constant conversation, and then it's like constant emails that I gotta send out right before our meetings or beforehand, and I gotta, you know, do executive board meets and stuff like that. So it's definitely the hardest part of the day is just like trying to get through that home.
But you know, when you have a good salad, it gives you a lot of energy. And it helps you get through the day. So that should help.
Unfortunately, it doesn't help when people come into the room and eat my salad without asking and then send me a picture and decide to say, hey, I ate your salad. It was in the dark and lonely and I decided to eat it. Things like that don't just happen.
But when people come in...
That's a very specific example you got there.
Well, you know, salads come
just
and go.
Just from the imagination.
Well, you know, salads come and go, man. It's like cake. People come in with cake all the time.
Yeah, it's not like they eat the forks or anything. Put the mouse all over.
And, you know, cookies. Clough cookies. John J. cookies.
Yeah, it's not like people just take them.
Yeah.
Not at all.
What else? So, you know, the room, space request, that type of stuff. It's all fun stuff.
Very, very fun.
Very fun. Because without, you know, space request, you don't have a room.
Yes, definitely. It's all you need is a room.
All you need is a room.
Because
if you have lube, you just eat the whole ass. Because it's like ketchup.
That's ketchup? The ass? The whole ass is ketchup?
Whole ass.
Is John Batista like the judge of that?
Yes. I don't know.
Is playing ass an instrument?
If you have mayonnaise.
Didn't you just say ketchup 2 seconds ago? So you like the color red and white mixing together. That's called a peppermint.
Or it's Russian dressing.
Have you ever had Russian dressing?
Yes, I have. It's delicious.
Dick? Grayson?
That's how Batman, that's Batman saved the city. You see, one time, you know, Godzilla attacked the city, and Superman's like, we need something, take it out, we need something, we need to take it out, it's just really powerful, really strong. And I was like, don't worry, I have a really big dick, Grayson. And Nightwing was out and saved the city, because Nightwing's the best.
It's the only, Robin I love, the dick, Grayson.
Yeah. So
what happens to Tariq? He's Robin.
He's banned.
Okay.
So they have a ban list of this Tariq on it?
We actually have in the Constitution, Tariq is banned on the bottom of the Constitution in bold red letters. Tariq, you're still banned.
What else? So Secretary comes in every morning, stays here pretty much all day, on the keyboard, you know, in the internet.
In the internet, not on it.
In the internet.
Yeah.
So like, when you get here, does that Yancey have an internet sword? And like upload your internet sword and go around fighting internet demons?
No, I gotta have
it. Isn't that Mega Man?
Yes. Yes. Sometimes,
No.
I have to go and erase his Pornhub history.
I mean, I hear that's where you get the good AMVs.
It's a good AMV. No, the good AMVs from XXHamper.
XHamster?
Because you get the AMVs.
Or horseporn.com.
What really matter?
Oh, boy.
Horseporn?
Horseporn.
Do you watch horseporn?
Bo Jackman horseporn is on Netflix and chill.
That's the only thing that matters.
It's the only thing that matters. The important things that matter in life.
Like the ass?
Like eating the whole ass.
The entire ass.
See, these are interviews with Steve. And interviews with Steve, they could go anywhere. Know why? Because I control nothing but everything at the same time.
Like space and time?
Space and time.
What if?
Know why?
What if you could control space and time?
Then I'd be a Time Lord.
Is that why there's like a police box?
Well, you see, I was shopping with my friend the doctor, and he dropped me off for some TV segments, but Anthony left in it.
Uh-huh.
I'm weird. So you were napping?
Yes. Yes, I was.
We probably have some dreams. I'll get back to that. Remember. And that was their interviews. And now you're going to see me in TV.
Comics.
In comics. You're going to see me in comics. You're going to see me in comics. And in comics, I have a special...
My name is Barry Allen. I'm the fastest man alive. I just went from there to here in under 4 seconds. Sorry to cut you off, but can I have you? Well, so you're here, you know, you can have them because you can do best in comics.
Deal.
So our guest star today, Mr. Tariq, if you don't know him, he is
banned.
So he's basically Quasla of trivia. Really? So
it's one time thing.
So recently DC has canceled a bunch of comics.
Like seven of them?
Seven of them, maybe?
Yeah, seven.
Seven. So the first one they one of the comics they canceled is Batman 66, which was literally the Adam West thing, continuation from the old series that everybody watched and kind of loved and kind of hated. And they brought it into comic book form. You saw the bat suit that had eyebrows and everything, and all the biff bands and pals you can imagine. So you know, if you're Batman Adam West, you're probably going to miss this, but.
Otherwise, there's other Batman.
There's other Batman what was more canon.
There's like, what, eight other Batman titles?
Yeah, there's a lot. There's a few. The next one that's canceled is Green Lantern, The Lost Army.
Which literally starts off with Green Lantern, like, waking up in an unknown location, and he's, like, you're trying to use his power ring to find a power battery, he can't find nothing, and there's no other Lantern cores around him, and he's just like, what the f-
Wait, not the first? Yeah.
What the fuck is going on?
Another fucking comic will get canceled. Is Justice League United,
which was formed after Forever Evil. All the teams the Justice League of America and a couple other like superheroes after the wake of Forever Evil were given special permission by the government to still form their own little superhero team, kind of like the Justice League of America was before Forever Evil.
We got the Omega Man. The Omega Man. And we got Lobo.
He's an intergalactic bounty hunter who likes to call himself the main man. I love that guy.
You can put extra points.
I love that guy. And they cancel him.
Yeah, I love him. Well, you know, is it as bad if Doomsday canceled it? Because in that comic, they canceled Doom.
They canceled Doom, which is about a teenager getting the Doomsday virus. That was inflicted into Superman in New 52 Superman issue about 28, and then it tied into like Action Comics and other the super shit. And he was affected with the Doomsday virus, and Superman had to save the kid before the Doomsday takes over him completely.
Before we have Marvel a bit. DC has released some covers for the new thing called Robin's War. Robin's War is all the Robins are heading back to Gotham, and they're going to be kicking each other's asses. And you know, RoboCop, Batman's going around, and you know, being RoboCop, Batman, and you're basically wrestling people with R's on their chest. But one of the really cool parts about this is on the covers, all the Robins are wearing the Court Owl masks,
which are amazing.
They're amazing. Like, it's kind of the bad, an artist's life through it.
I mean, it's not accurately.
But you know, I'm really hyped because I think it's finally going to finish up for the Owls. You're finally going to see with Grayson and the Owls.
Yeah,
it's pretty awesome.
Because Grayson's actually not that bad.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. Mm-hmm.
I like it.
Someone else does. It's pretty awesome.
And now on to Marvel.
Marvel. Okay, so Marvel has released a whole new post Secret Wars list of comics, and one of the titles they released is a totally new Awesome Hulk. What's going to no longer Bruce Banner is no longer Hulk. It is now Amadeus Cho. Amadeus Cho, if you don't know, he's the seventh smartest man in the Marvel Universe. Pretty much equally as smart as Bruce Banner, but he accepts the Hulk and he can control it better than Bruce Banner can. And it's interesting because it's written by a Korean man, Frank Cho, so to be the first ever Asian American hero written by an Asian American writer, which should bring really interesting storylines.
Diversity.
Mm-hmm. That is all for the comic books this week. So thank you, Tariq. You're not banned for speaking with the comic books.
Thank you. And thanks for the Yu-Gi-Oh card.
Now we set it to anime.
True. And we're going to continue on now with our anime news panel thing. So,
hi, I'm the guy from the segment before. Talk about comics, but now I teleported to this room because I'm fancy like that with a tie. My name is Steve. If you're still here, and we're gonna put some anime stuff.
I have no idea what's going on anymore.
Well,
that sounds about
if
right.
You watch Pokemon, you know they announced X, Y, and Z the anime. So maybe you might finally get Z the game.
Oh, Z is gonna be slated. This happened last time actually when Black 1 and Black 2 came out and they started to go with Black 2 and White 2. if predictions are correct, then the next Pokemon game will come out sometime during the summer. But with X, Y, and Z, also have news on like Ash's Greninja being a special variant of Greninja, and with Zygarde being a perfect Cell form because he's fucking Cell,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah, and Zygarde dog.
Yeah, so yeah. So, in other news, we also have a myriad of anime ending recently, with notable ones being like Shokugeki no Soma, Prison School ending in 2 weeks, Shin Myota, which is translates to a world without the concept of dirty jokes ending soon. But this also means that our next lineup of winter anime come out starting in 2 weeks. So be looking on the forward for that. In other anime news, in American anime news, Black Lagoon Premium Edition Blu-ray anime trailer surfaces. So Funimation's putting on another Blu-ray edition of Black Lagoon compacted with both the Roberto's Blood Trail OVA with the original Black Lagoon, which should be slated for about $100 if you care about that.
So you can bring Bay over and Sir Chris.
He likes Crunchyroll and Jill.
Sir Chris sings a little bit, I think.
Does anyone Hulu and Hang?
Hulu and Hang? No, because I don't want to kill myself.
No one's plus enough for that.
Jesus, no. Damn. In other anime news that are just random and I just want to bring up, Shokugeki gets certain items that will be very hilarious and or very promisable for certain people. We have 3 body pillows in the shapes of Aldini, Soma, and Shinomiya, Aldini shaking his butt on his pillow. And we also have, for those who also like, the Opai mouse pads for Nikumi, Alice, and Reina. They all cost $50 a piece. So, be looking forward on Crunchyroll.com for those.
My fucking stonk.
Can't wait to get those notifications.
In more mod news, Digimon Adventure 3 is coming out in a 6-part series where they're bringing back their original Digidestins. So, you know, you're going to get Tai, Miyamoto, TK in English.
This is the English name.
Mimi, Joe, Izzy. but this isn't still cake.
Or salads.
Or cookies.
He's a fish. He's just a giant Digimon. Awesome.
You look like someone just ate your salad.
I ate my cake.
He could not eat his cake.
So see, like, we're gonna get
the cake is really a lie this time, huh?
Yeah. And in popularity anime news, we have Charlotte, which has dropped on the charts from taking the top spot down to 3rd, I believe, with what is it called again? Unamarahina-chan? I don't remember the name of it, but it's an anime about a little girl who's into anime. Because, you know, people like those kinds of things. Taking the top spot for this week, but we'll see what happens later on. We'll keep you updated as the messages go on, and my phone is not in operable service.
So in the money printing department,
was that because you work at the corporate lawyership of
McDonald's?
No,
the mind printing department. Naruto has a new game, the Naruto Ninja 4. Because, you know, more money. You know, Naruto never dies. So Birdo and Sarp and Salad is in the game.
Motherfucking money.
And also
Michael Bay.
And also in the motherfucking money department is the One Piece game. So we get Gear 4 Luffy. So it's pretty cool. So yeah.
And for all you Doflamingo fans and LOL lovers, you know, you get to finally square out your Doflamingo versus Law arguments, so there you go.
I have a question. Has Log Horizon 3 been confirmed yet?
It has neither been confirmed nor denied.
And SAL still sucks.
SAL is still ongoing with their 4th game incoming.
And their 3rd season already in development. It's getting better, though.
We'll see how it goes.
Oh, and, it's anime related, but, you know, Attack on Titan, their manga is having a big announcement at, New York Comic Con, so look out for that. The anime show hasn't been released yet.
Yeah, AOT2 is still scheduled for 2016, so somewhere around spring we'll get the 2nd season. So all you diehard AOT fans can, you know, finally rest in peace when you know that nothing is inside that cellar, and it's just, you know, nothing. It's just a porn stash.
But bring your potatoes.
Yeah, oh, bring your potatoes. Potatoes are the best girl. Best girl.
My wife.
Yeah, best wife. Followed by Armin.
Armin. And to the weather.
And robot weather. I think we should just go to video games now.
Alright, see you guys. See you again later.
Hi there, GNC.
I am the newsroom editor-in-chief. My name is Anthony, as I'm sure you all know. And I am joined here today by GNC President Yancey. And we will be taking this time to introduce our newest segment. Basically, we will be talking about video game news that recently came out and just talking about video games in general. Yancey, if you want to start off.
All right, so we have two big pieces of information this week. The first big one will probably be Pokemon Go announced for cell phone smart games. It's made by a group of people on Google who actually created a big game on the cell phone before. So Pokemon Go does have a big following already to it. So hopefully we all get to catch the 151 again on our cell phones sometime in 2016. The second big piece of news this week will also be that Nintendo has announced their new president. His name is Tatsumi Kimishima. That's right, we have a Mishima from Tekken as our founder of Nintendo now. Well, not founder, but president. But yeah, so those are the big two pieces of news coming up from this week. On side news, TGS, which is actually the Tokyo Game Show, aired this week. And we got to see a bunch of new games coming out from Japan, like the new trailer for Persona 5, which will be delayed shortly till 2016. Dark Souls 3 has new mechanics that were introduced that are coming back into the game, such as a new Estus flask for your magic meter, and other games such as Uncharted 4 will have betas coming out in December.
Oh, thank you, baby Jesus!
And actually, the Taken King DLC has already been data mined, so there's a list of all the items you can get for everybody who's ready for that expansion to fully come out.
For those of you who don't already know, the Destiny has an interesting place in all of our hearts. For those of us that got it when it first came out, basically that when it first came out, it was probably the epitome of the biggest disappointment I've ever seen in my life. However, from what I'm understanding, this Taken King is the best DLC they've ever released, and it adds just content upon content upon content. And if you're not broke like I am, you should probably go buy it.
I also heard that the newest updates also took away the light level system.
They did. So armor does not level you up. You yourself have to level yourself up.
Which is a goddamn blessing.
It's a goddamn blessing because at a point, you just don't know if you're going to be able to find better armor without being more of a hassle than it already is.
Yeah, so for all those who, myself included, hated Destiny before, I've heard that there's various improvements into the game, so it might get me into it now. So we'll see how that goes. In other news, we also have Danganronpa 3 being announced for 2016, and we also have Ace Attorney 6 being announced for the 3DS, as well with a Shokugeki no Soma game for those who like anime, coming out in Japan for the 3DS, and for all you AOT fans, there is a actual Attack on Titan game for the PS4 coming soon to Japan, and hopefully, with as much boom as we all know Attack on Titan has, will come over to the seas in the PS4 2017.
Speaking of PS4s, I hear you can get a gold one nowadays. If you eat a lot of Mexican food, you can get a gold PS4.
Mexican food. So Taco Bell are doing deals with, if you remember the Destiny, get a free copy of PS4 and Destiny if you get this code on your Taco Bell box. So Taco Bell is once again sponsoring PS4 with golden PS4s.
Because it's Taco Bell,
and
white people get drunk, so they could buy stuff.
Yeah,
so,
that's a good thing.
I mean, look, when you make fake burritos and fajitas for a living, you make money, you know?
Tell that to the people working in lower class.
Those are real fajitas and burritos.
Yeah. And for Kingdom Hearts fans, because I know all of you are diehard fanatics, there is a new Kingdom Hearts game coming out before Kingdom Hearts 3. Wow.
There's a shock.
2.8. Yes, 2.8 is scheduled for release sometime
later. Are you sure we're talking about Final Fantasy?
No. Kingdom Hearts 2.8, coming out later next year, will come out before Kingdom Hearts 3, and it is actually the re-releases of the 3DS games, from what I've heard. So you can now play them all on one console. Well, not one. You can't even play it on one, because you still got to buy a PS3 to buy 1.5 and 2.5, and now you got to buy a PS4 to play 2.8.
And then 3 when it eventually comes out.
And then 3 when it eventually comes out. So hopefully you have good news there. So if you've never had a 3DS, this is your chance to pick up 2.8, which also apparently comes with a demo disc for Final Fantasy XV.
Speaking of franchises that just keep adding and adding, Assassin's Creed made an announcement. Jack the Ripper is coming via DLC, which if you know who Jack the Ripper is and you know what Assassin's Creed likes to do every once in a while of history is exciting if you want to stop prostitutes from being murdered in very, very, very gruesome ways. Although the only thing I don't understand is that Jack the Ripper doesn't reappear until I think 20 years after what after the year that this game takes place.
Sometime around that time.
So we're gonna have a slightly older, protagonist, assuming they both come out alive.
Twins.
Well, yeah, with twins, you never know. Like, now with two, one can die.
Twins, so far.
No, they are twins. They're twins.
Twins.
Okay, Jupiter won't kill these twins this time.
We hope. We can only hope that these guys don't get hit by lightning this time.
So I think that's it that we have.
I think that's all that there really is to talk about via video games. Stay tuned, where our ending card will be coming up right now. We hope you enjoyed our video game segment. Please leave comments about video games you'd like us to talk about for our next broadcast. Anything else you'd like to say?
Video games are awesome. Get both if you can. PC sucks.
Alright, GNC, I hope you enjoyed the newsroom's first episode of the semester. There's a lot more to come for the weeks to come, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please leave any comments you have down below. I read them all. If you want to tell us something we think we can improve on, something you'd like us to address, write down below. Also, I would like to tag our new email, gncnewsroom@gmail.com. You can send us emails of questions you'd like us to answer on Newsroom or on another segment that we may have in the future. I'm Anthony. I am editor-in-chief, I guess, of Newsroom. I hope you have a good day. Still here. It's over. Go home.